Are you looking to buy some meat rabbits, but you're wondering what exactly do you look for in a meat rabbit when it comes to picking out a specific one for your breeders? That's what we're going to talk about in today's video, so stick around. Hey guys, welcome back to another Slightly Rednecked video. Again, my name is Chris, and if you're not familiar with this channel, I help you to produce your own meat, eggs, and vegetables from your backyard, your balcony, your deck, your garage, or heck, even a spare room in your house if that's the way you want to do it. And today we're talking about meat rabbits and specifically what to look for when it comes to selecting your breeding stock. Now, I've done videos before on what's the best breed of meat rabbit, so that's not really what I'm going to be talking about in this video. This is more about when you're looking at specific rabbits, what do you look for before you buy one and bring it home and make it a breeder for your future meat rabbits. Okay, so first of all, you're probably best off sticking with purebred stock if you really want good meat rabbits. Something that is registered maybe, or at least pedigreed, so you can track their bloodlines. They're purebred New Zealands, California, Silver Foxes. Like I said, there's lots of breeds, and you can check out my video on the best breeds of meat rabbits if you want to do that. But with that being said, when it comes to a specific rabbit, what you're looking for is you want to be able to check a couple of things. Let me get my buck out here and I'll show you. He's a good example of a good meat rabbit, and I'll show you kind of some specifics here. He's kind of blowing his coat right now, so he looks a little bit, fur is a little messed up and all, but I think we'll still be able to show you some things. Let me grab a hold of him real quick. Okay, so this is my California buck, and he's, like most rabbits, he likes the attention, he likes to be petted and stuff, but like most rabbits, he really doesn't like to be picked up, but he's pretty calm and pretty mellow, and that's one thing that you want to look out for a rabbit, one that you can handle fairly easily. Some of these guys, there's no way I'd handle them with short sleeves on because they can get pretty wiry, kick, and scratch the heck out of you. But aside from that, aside from their temperament, making sure that it's something you can handle pretty well, and like I said, good grief, fur going everywhere, some things you want to look for. You want to look for a boxy rabbit, a big, you can kind of see he's just like a little block of meat. You can't feel him, but boy, he's just nothing but solid muscle. You want to feel down here on their hind end, make sure that they're good and solid right there. You don't feel their backbone sticking up or anything like that. Check their loins right here, right behind their neck. Make sure that you feel good muscle, good meat right there, because those are the parts of the rabbit that are going to produce the most meat. And again, make sure that they're not real bony, make sure they're not real lanky, anything like that. You don't feel their spine sticking up through there. A couple other things that you want to check out, good grief, let me get some of this, is make sure that their ears are clean, and you can see his ears are clean. Well, maybe you can see that on camera, but check their ears, make sure their ears are clean, make sure their eyes are bright, his eyes are clear and bright. Calm down there, buddy. Poor guy. Let me put him back up and I'll continue talking here real quick. All right, got fur all over me here. Okay, so those are a couple of things that you want to check for with meat rabbits. Now, I just bought a new rabbit. I was at the poultry swap this weekend, found one that I really liked, and I bought this rabbit. Let me get her out. I'll show you real quick what she looks like. Okay, so this is my newest rabbit right here. Bought her at the poultry swap this weekend, and she is I was told she's got some Flemish Giant in her, Flemish Giant cross of some kind. Pretty decent sized rabbit. She's a little bit on the thin side. She does not really meet all that criteria I just told you about by looking at a boxy rabbit, looking for good meaty loins and good meaty hind end. You see she's a little bit lanky. Maybe you can tell that on camera, maybe you can't. She's a little bit on the thin side. Now, the guy I got her from said that he kind of backs off on the feeding in the summer, so she's lost a little bit of weight. I'm going to fatten her up. I've got a couple of months before breeding season starts up, so this was a good time to go ahead and pick a rabbit out and get her going. But she's easy enough to handle. Her eyes are nice and bright. She's real attentive. Her ears are looking clean. No problems with her ears. And like I said, no problem handling her, so that's a good sign for me. And really, it kind of depends a little bit on what you're looking for. Oh, one more thing to check is you always want to check their feet. I don't know if I can show this or not. Check their feet, make sure that you don't have any problems with sore hocks on their feet, anything like that. And her feet look good. There's no problems right there. You don't want to bring a rabbit home that has big scabs on the bottoms of their back feet or anything like that. It's a sign of sore hocks. It can be a genetic thing that they can pass on to their young. But the reason I picked this rabbit out is just because I just wanted some unique colors in my breeds. Whenever I breed these guys out, I want to get some kind of cool looking colors and some different colored rabbits instead of just the white ones. And she fits the bill pretty well. Like I said, she's a sweetheart. She's easy to handle. Not bad to deal with. So that fits the bill on that. And, if her babies don't grow out fast enough, Well, that's not that big of a loss. She was a $6-7 rabbit, I think is what I paid for her. So she was cheap, easy to come by. The guy I got her from said she's a proven breeder. She's bred before. She has big litters, somewhere around 10 rabbits per litter. That's one thing that you want to ask about. Make sure that you may not be able to tell that about the rabbit that you're picking out, but if you know the parents and they've had big litters, then chances are that rabbit's going to have big litters as well. So you want to look for big litters. You also want to look for fast grow out and find out if the babies will grow out to butcher weight, about 4 to 5 pounds, within about 8 weeks, 8 to 10 weeks, somewhere right around in there. Now, the guy I bought her from said that her babies get to fryer size. Oh, excuse me. Got rabbit fur all over the place from my buck. Okay, so the guy I bought her from said that her babies got to fryer size within about 8 to 10 weeks. Now, I don't know what he considers fryer size, and he may have just been feeding me a line. I kind of have doubts with her being Flemish Giant, or having some Flemish Giant blood in her anyway, that her babies are going to grow out that fast. But we'll see whenever I go to breed her. And like I said, it's not that big of a loss if she's not for me. But that's something that you may be terribly concerned about. And if that's the case, again, I would stick more with purebred rabbits instead of getting mutts like this. But the cool thing about getting mutts like this, the mixed breeds, is that you do get some nice colors out of them. You do get some pretty rabbits. And that's kind of what I was looking for with this one here. I've got good meat stock with my California buck, my silver fox doe back here, which is hiding in the corner, and she's a black rabbit, so you probably can't see her on film anyway because she's hiding back in the shadows. So I wanted something to just kind of add some color and some variety to my stock, so that's why I got this rabbit. But let me get her put back up. She's pretty calm right now, but she'll be more happy in her cage, so let me put her back up. All right, so again, the biggest thing, look for the temperament. Look for rabbits you can handle like that. And you notice I just picked those guys up. I didn't have to scruff them by the neck or anything like that. Maybe you didn't see that part on camera, but my arms, not scratched up. I don't need any stitches. I don't need any bandages. That is an incredibly important thing. Not all rabbits are that easy to handle. And it is truly a nightmare when you have a rabbit that you just cannot hardly get out of the cage without it just scratching the heck out of you. So really look for the temperament on them, aside from the other things that I talked about. So, again, if you're looking more for breed information on what breeds are going to be good, I've got a video on that. But those are a couple of things when it comes to looking at these specific rabbits that you pick out that you're going to want to look for when it comes to picking your breeding stock. So hopefully that helps you out a little bit. Leave me a comment below. Let me know. Is there something I forgot? Something else that you look at whenever it comes to rabbits? One thing I will say is it's really best to quarantine any new rabbits you bring into your rabbit sheds, your rabbit breeding colonies, whatever. Put them in a separate cage all by themselves away from your other rabbits for, you know, at least a couple of weeks, probably up to 30 days. I didn't do that. I'm not, you know, following my own advice on that. I'm just assuming she's okay. The guy had plenty of rabbits there. I've seen him there before. He's sold before. I know him somewhat. So I kind of trust that he's taking care of his rabbits really well. None of the rabbits looked sick. They all looked really healthy. They're all, you know, looked pretty good. So I'm just taking a chance with that. And if I get some kind of a disease that just wipes out my whole flock, well, I'm only losing 3 rabbits. And it would be terrible. It would be sad. But I'm kind of taking a chance here. You may not want to do that with yours. Again, it's best to really quarantine them. But anyway, again, leave me a comment below. Let me know. Is there something I forgot? Something else you look for? Thank you guys so much for watching this video. And as always, God bless.